what Jesus Christ has given us. That's all he has. The devil don't have any kind of other weapon to fight against you. The pride of the lust of the flesh, the lust of the spirit, and the pride of life. He was throwing all those at Jesus Christ. He used it on Eve. She saw the fool, the lust of the eye. It was pleasant to the eyes, the lust of the eye, the other one, the lust of the flesh. And then she made it and she ate with the pride of life. But Jesus Christ did not eat. He was no less than God and God all by himself. The concept of commitment in these days and times, if thou be the Son of God, come down from the cross.
Yeah.
If you be the Son of God, you have certain right and certain inheritance. And it was trying to tell Jesus, trying to tempt Jesus. And I'm here to tell you today, you know if the enemy tempted Jesus Christ, what he going to do to you? We cry out every Wednesday night, and you still have the same faithful few. Jesus Christ says, hold on, because the word is the only thing that prepares you to fight against the enemy. You lose the fight because you're using the wrong weapon. The only weapon that you could fight against the enemy today, I'm here to present to some and tell others that you're using the wrong weapon. Jesus Christ said that, for it is written. We can't say that it's written because we never do pick up our Bibles. We never do read and understand what the Word of God says.
Yeah.
I'm here to tell you today, there's power in the Word of God. There's salvation in God's Word. And Jesus was preparing for the loneliness. And he said, come on, Satan, and hit me with what you got. Somebody's been to Bible study day in and day out. Somebody's been faithful to come to choir practice. Jesus Christ tells you to hold on and to hold out. For we go, and when we go through this daily task, we got bills on every corner. People are being unfaithful. Then we got to turn around and go to a job. Jesus Christ says that he sees you. He knows your heart. He says, hold on, for the tempter have, for he have overcome. So he told Satan to come on, Satan. He was prepared for the tempter, and he was led by the Spirit. You can hear him tell the Satan to come on, Satan. For over in the next chapter, it will tell us that John the Baptist was in prison. He was saying that he had some blinded eyes to open up. He had some people that was lame he needed to make walk. He had some people that was dumb that he needed to make talk. He needed some ears to let to unstop their ears. Let's move on with this. So Jesus Christ, after he was tempted, the devil left him. And soon the devil will leave you. And behold, the angels came and ministered to him. For all your work that you're doing, Jesus Christ said your work will not be left in vain. And all the things that you were doing, Jesus Christ said that you can look to the sky and the angels is coming to minister to you. They're on your way for a church without a spot or wrinkle. For Jesus Christ told him that there are some eyes I need to open up today. There is somebody that's lame and sick that I need to touch and make well.
Yeah.
The angels is coming. He said that you've been toiling all your life and been doing all these good things. He said, stop it. Don't worry about it. You made yourself into a robot. He said, don't worry. He said, the angels is coming. Well, you know that Jesus Christ, after he healed all the sick and made the lame walk and the blind see, you know that a few circus people decided to crucify him. And they marched him from judgment hall to judgment hall. They carried him from one area to another area. And Paul says that I find no fault with this man. They said that and the only reason why the people decided to crucify him is that the people who are outside the church says crucify him, and the church stood silent. It's by and by, it's time for the church to stop being silent. It's time for the church. If thou be the church, you need to be praying on Wednesday night. If thou be the church, you need to be healing people, touching people, and helping people out instead of saying all manner of evil against them. If thou be the church, you don't need to wear your cross. You need to be the cross, because Jesus Christ was marched up Golgotha's hill, and they hung him between two thieves. And one of the thieves said, if thou be the Christ, you save us or save us. In the name of Jesus, he said, if thou be the Christ, I'm here to present to some and tell others today, if thou be the church, it's time for you to just quit coming to God's house and sitting down and not saying nothing. God says that you have the power to call down legions of angels. The only thing you have to do is open your mouth. In the name of Jesus, you have time to go and see the sick, to make the lame walk. You got a lot of people in jail that have lost their way. They have a lot of families that need help. In the name of Jesus, if thou be the church, they hung him on Golgotha's hill from the sixth to the ninth hour. And they say that the sun refused to shine. And they say that the moon dripped in blood. And they say he stayed there all night Friday night. And he stayed there all night Saturday night. But early Sunday morning, he got up. Didn't he get up, Brother Woods? He got up for you this morning. Sister Burns, didn't he get up? He got up for you, Brother Scott. He got up for you, Sister Steele. He got up with all power of heaven and earth in his hand. That's why he was saying that don't be weary in well doing, because in due season you're going to reap if you faint not. And he said, after a while, by and by, the wicked is going to cease from troubling. After a while, you won't have to worry about getting up in the morning. After a while, you won't have to worry about people lying on you no more. After a while, you won't have to worry about paying these old bills and worry about situations and circumstances. He said, after a while, by and by, he'll be back for his church without a spot or a wrinkle. If the devil tempted Jesus Christ, that will let you know where you stand. If you don't read your Bible, people, I implore you to read your Bible, to come to Wednesday night on Bible study. If you don't pray, the tempter is already here, and he's trying to deceive whoever whom he can. Be praying for one another. The doors of the church are now open. It's not going to get easier. And we see that the enemy is trying to make it as difficult as possible. order and order.